And now we're going to talk about different characteristics that are the shapes of distributions, right? So these are the shapes of histograms, basically. And we're going to start off talking about something called the normal distribution. And this is the best known distribution. All right, so this is basically a frequency a histogram. It looks something like that. All right, so this is going to be the mean. It's going to have a standard deviation over here, right, and then two standard deviations over there. The normal distribution is a specific frequency distribution. By specific, I mean every normal distribution that's ever existed has had the exact same specific shape. In fact, there is a formula that describes this shape, which is y times e to the exponent mu squared divided by 2 sigma. So all normal distributions fit this formula. So that describes this shape. So it's a very specific shape, and it's always the same. You don't need to know that formula or anything. I just wanted to let you know this is the exact specific shape. And so, for example, something that has the shape is IQ in humans is distributed in a normal distribution, right? So you have a mean of 100, standard deviation of 15 for that. And as you're like reading textbooks or, you know, looking at various normal distributions, sometimes you'll see it kind of squished up. But if it's normal, for example, for IQ, it'll still have, it's still a normal distribution. And all that's happened is, in this case, the horizontal axis was squished together, right? Or sometimes you'll see it spread out more. It looks like there's more variability here than here, but if the normal distributions, they are exactly the same as each other, and all that's happened is whoever has drawn it just drew it wider, or drew it skinnier, or drew it pretty accurately. So all normal distributions have the exact same shape as one another, no matter how they're depicted visually. And the normal distribution has, in addition to an exact shape, three notable characteristics. One is that it is bell-shaped, right? So it kind of looks like a bell. You can imagine maybe the little thing hanging down that goes ding, ding, ding inside there. It is symmetrical, right? So if you, it is symmetrical. So that would mean if you cut it right in the middle and as a piece of paper and folded it over, the two halves would perfectly align with one another. Or if you held a mirror to one side, right, it would look exactly the same on either side. So it's symmetrical. Just like a person can be symmetrical if they're exactly the same on one side as the other. And the other feature it has is it's unimodal. Remember, the mode is the most common score. And when we're talking about unimodal, all that means is there's one peak. There's a single peak, right? So there's just this one peak here in the middle. So normal distributions are bell-shaped, they're symmetrical, and they only have one peak. So if you ever see a distribution that kind of looks like that, not normal because it's not a normal distribution because it's bimodal. It's also not symmetrical, and that would be a strange-looking bell. So those are some of the key characteristics of a normal distribution, and we will be using normal distributions throughout the whole semester. They have more characteristics that we're going to talk about a little bit later.